Okay, so we're in the field at the Subsurface Drip Irrigation Research, and right below me is one of the drip lines. So the way this is installed is drip tape is pulled through the field using something that looks like a ripper shank, so a big tooth that goes in the ground, that the drip tape is installed 16 inches below the soil surface. And that's done every 60 inches. So imagine there's one tape underneath me, the next middle between the next two rows of corn, there's nothing, but the next one has a piece of drip tape underneath it. And that's all hooked into the manifolds that we saw earlier. So at any point in time, based on the program and the soil moisture data, the drip tape below me would come on for a couple hours and slowly apply water at the rate of about a half of a tenth per hour. So in order to put on an inch of water, we're going to have to run this system somewhere in the neighborhood of 20 hours to put on an inch of water. And we do that very slowly. We want that water to go slow so it has the time to wick through that soil profile to kind of go up towards the top. The advantage of this system in certain soil types is because we're not wetting the soil surface like we would with a sprinkler type irrigation system, there's not the risk of having evaporative loss from the soil. So evaporation of water doesn't benefit the crop at all. We want to maximize transpiration, the amount of water being pulled up by the soil, by the plant roots, and being transpired into the air. That's what makes grain yield. That's what makes us a crop, vegetables, or any other crop. So by reducing the amount of wetness that's on the surface, we're hoping to reduce the amount of evaporation. This is not too new technology. It's been around for more than 30 years. It started in Israel, and it works very well on heavy soil types that have a lot of loam, a lot of organic matter content, a lot of clays. This is in sand, which is a unique situation that's not ideal for subsurface drip because the coarse soil doesn't wick that moisture away. It tends to let gravity take over and pull it down. So what we're trying to evaluate here is how efficient are we from a water standpoint when we've got a sandy soil type. This field happens to have quite a bit of clay on one side and sand on the other side. So it gives us the opportunity to compare the two situations. We are hoping that this system is going to be functional for 20 years. In other parts of the country, it's been used for 20 to 30 years. But the challenges are water quality primarily, whether we have iron or hard water that may precipitate out and plug the drip emitters. Iron-eating algae tend to be a problem because the algae can plug that emitter. So we do some chlorinations to prevent the algae buildup in the lines. And we're also concerned about rodents. Rodents will burrow and try and put a hole in the tape because they're seeking water too. So we have groundhogs and foxes and that type of thing tend to cause problems. And finally, we've got insects that do travel through the soil profile that will put holes in them, particularly wireworms. We haven't had wireworm troubles here yet, but we're, you know, kind of keeping an eye out to make sure it doesn't happen. Overall, we're learning a lot about how this system works. It's in sandy soil types, this is an opportunity for growers to irrigate fields that are shaped in such a way that an irrigation system, a center pivot type irrigation system, doesn't fit. I don't know that it's a water conservation tool in sand. It's more of a tool to irrigate previously unirrigatable land due to the economics.